that is the part which is collecting the rainfall, and mouth of that measuring jar, a glass jar, they are of the that area of that funnel, mouth of the funnel, and area of the mouth of the measuring jar is in the ratio of 1:10. Because it is like that, when the suppose when you pour the rain water in the measuring jar and it is at the height of 100 mm, so it gives 100 mm directly. There you need not apply any correction, you need not apply any reduction table and all. So even in a small thing, just measuring and pouring, you cannot use any measure like what they use in a grocery shop for measuring the oil, or milk shop, or in the petrol bunk, small measuring jar we are there using for putting the oil for TVS 50 and all, no? So like that, you cannot use any sort of measure. Each rain jar is having a corresponding measuring glass. Only that measuring glass can be used. This is for the automatic rain jar station. Okay. This is for the ordinary rain jars. For self-recording rain jars, there is a small cylindrical container in which there will be a float. When the rain is falling in that funnel and going through the tube, it will be collected in that container. When the water gets collected in the container, that float will start floating up. A pen is attached with that float. That pen will start marking on a chart. This chart is wound over a drum. This drum is fitted over a clock. You give winding to the clock every week. So the clock rotates. As it rotates, chart which is wound over is having divisions of time. So, and the appropriate time it will mark. So, up to 10 mm of rainfall, the pin will go to the top of that graph. Then, due to the weight of the water column inside the container, there one valve will get opened in the bottom, all the water will drain out. So, the pin will come down again. Valve get closed, further rainfall, more collection of water, more the float will go up, like this process will go on. This is what is called as self-recording rain gauge. That picture only I have given in this book here. This picture is this is that picture which is showing a picture of the chart that is wound over a self-recording rain gauge. So the rain has started very slowly in the form of drizzle. The drizzle has continued for more than 2 hours, 3 hours. Then a sharp rain, it has gone up to this. Then no rainfall, flat curve. Then again rainfall has started. So it reached 10 mm, so the tank got emptied, came down. Then here this spell is really heavy spell, because during a short span of time this goes up. Similarly, again, continuously up to this time, sharp, very good rain. So, the intensity of the rainfall, amount of the rainfall, everything can be obtained from this chart. The other one which is used in automatic weather stations and automatic rain gauges, that is called as tipping bucket rain gauge, that there will be two small cups. Again, that funnel type arrangement only. One cup will be just below the funnel tube. When rain is falling, rain will get collected in that cup. When this cup becomes full, due to weight, this will slide down. And the other cup will come below the funnel. This will get empty. When this cup gets filled up, this will slide down this side. So when it is sliding this down, this will go and touch one electrical contact there. That will send a signal. One signal received means that cup full of rain is received. That is 2.5 or 0.5 mm rainfall is received. The cup size will be known. This is how automatic rain gauges, the rain is measured. This is how overall rain is measured.
My question is, what is the rainfall pattern in Chennai?
Sipin, you know normally during the months of January, February, March, Chennai don't get rain at all, except yesterday. Yesterday morning we had a rare rainfall. But normally we do not have. That's why. During January 14, 15, when Pongal holidays are there used to be a test match always in Chepauk Road. Because this is the period where we will not get rainfall at all. And that's why they used to keep a test match there. See, we get rainfall during the southwest monsoon period. For the annual rainfall of Chennai, about 42% is recorded during the southwest monsoon period. About 54% is recorded during the northeast monsoon period. Southwest monsoon period, rain bearing clouds form in the west direction, move towards the sea and give rain to Chennai city. Northeast monsoon period, clouds form in the sea, come from the sea and give rain to the Chennai city. Winds bringing enough moisture and a small convergence due to which the winds are going up. So they give rainfall. This is the pattern of rainfall in Chennai. Chennai gets rainfall both during southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon. Southwest monsoon above 40%, northeast monsoon above 55%, and other months also a small amount of rain. Southwest monsoon clouds come from west direction and give rain. Northeast monsoons, clouds come from east and give rain. This is the pattern of rainfall in Chennai.
Children, good afternoon, sir. We are from Kendriya Vidyalaya number 2, Tambaram. I am Mrs. KV Kamala Sundaram, TGT English there. Here is my team. We are doing a project on rain, pain or gain. And here we have children, Sri KV Balasubramanian, Assistant Meteorologist, Regional Meteorological Center, College Road, Chennai. So here we have my team. We have Badri, we have Tushar Bhatt, we have Vasi Anjum, I have here Gaurav Sharma, Anuj, Sabarish and Shivin, along with my team member Anish and here sir. So would you please help us in finding out certain answers for a few questions of my students.
I am happy to be with you students. What exactly your project?
Sir, our project is to first of all know how much rain is useful for us, then how rain helps in agriculture, and as the rain is very important, then how we can harvest rainwater, then what are the types of cloud, how rain comes, then what are the types of precipitation, and what is the rainfall pattern of Chennai, then how we can protect the rainfall, then how we can how many days it takes for how many days it takes for predicting the rainfall, then what are the instruments used for predicting rainfall, then if these instruments are not working, then how we can predict, and by looking at the clouds, if we are moving outside, then how we can predict rain.
And we also include the social issue of whether the society, the community is ready for rainy days.
Good, very nice. Show your questions.
Sir, my question is, what are cyclones, then what are the types of cyclones, and what are the names of cyclones that have already hit Chennai, and how we can predict these cyclones?
What are cyclones? I will start from that. It's a big question. Yes. In MSc meteorology course, this is about 40 marks question. That means we have to write about 20 pages at least. So, you asked me a difficult question, I will try to make it easy. See, low pressure systems that forms in sea are called as cyclones. So, all low pressure systems are not called as cyclones. They have different stages. First, they are low pressure area. Then, they intensify to become depression. then they intensify to become deep depression, then they intensify to become cyclone. Afterwards, they become severe cyclone, very severe cyclone, then super cyclone. So, you should visit our website www.imd.gov.in. In that, there is a link called cyclone. If you click that link, you will go to cyclone page. There is a link FAQ. I will show you. Okay, I am not having it. So, we are not getting it. So, this in that you have got a link called cyclone. If you open that cyclone page, there you have another link called FAQ, frequently asked questions on cyclone. There all your questions are put there and all your answers are there. Okay, so for detailed answer, please you have to check the website. Then how they form? They form when the systems form only slightly away from the equator, because there is a force called as Coriolis force. This Coriolis force bends the movement of a air passer when it is moving in northern hemisphere and as well as southern hemisphere in different directions. But this Coriolis force is absent nearer to the equator. So we are at 10 degree now. Our geographical motion starts from 10 degree now. So our sea is very much having the Coriolis force. So Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea are suitable place as far as Coriolis force is concerned. Then the temperature of the sea water should be above 26 degrees Celsius. We call it as warm. So if the sea is warm, there cyclone can form. Two best seasons in which cyclones are forming is from April 15th to May end and from October to December. During the southwest monsoon period, the lower level winds are strong. They are about 25 kilometers per hour speed. So cyclones cannot form. So when the lower level winds are slightly less weak only, the cyclones can form. Because cyclone means from all over the surface, the winds will come and converge at one place. So all the moisture will come and converge at one place. So when they are converging, automatically the moisture has to go up. So they go up and forms clouds. So this is what is cyclone. Okay. So this how we are naming the cyclone. This naming of cyclone started from early 2004. Before that we were not having names. There is a panel called as RSMC panel. In that there are 6 countries: India, Pakistan, Maldives, Sri Lanka, Thailand, Burma, like that, Oman. Including Oman, there are about 8 countries. These countries, they have given, each has given one name. Like that, one list of 10 names they have given. The countries are arranged in alphabetical order. The names given by the each country is put one below the other, and one name is selected whenever the cyclone is forming. That is, from the stage of deep depression to cyclone, when it becomes, the name is given. Before that it is not given. Before that it is called as depression, deep depression only. When it becomes cyclone, we give the name by picking up the name from the list. Okay. Up to today, there are about 28 names you have exhausted. Again, the names of these cyclones are available in that website, FAQ portion, you can see. So, last year, October, November season, we had 4 cyclones. Last one is Maddy. Helen, Philin, sure. Like that, 4 names. There are 4 names are there. So, the last cyclone's name is Maddy. The other one, if the net is available, I will show you. It's not available. Okay, next. Start out.
Sir, my name is S.S. Samash. Sir, how many days before cyclones can be predicted?
Okay. Cyclones. See, cyclones of Indian region, only I am talking. Okay, cyclones are there in the Pacific Ocean, very big ocean. So where operates formation, before it comes to the coast, it may take 10 days, 11 days and all. Whereas the Indian Ocean, the area is less only. So after formation, 4 or 5 days it will come to us. Okay? You know, when they form as a low pressure, they cannot be detected by any other source except satellite. So satellite finds some mass of cloud is organizing at one place. So that can be a low pressure area like that, it may tell. Then as it further intensify, it starts moving also. Generally it moves in a west northwestward direction. In northern hemisphere, we are in northern hemisphere. So in northern hemisphere, all low pressure systems used to move only in a west northwest direction. So they come to the east coast. Whatever the cyclone low pressure system forms in the Bay of Bengal, they come to the east coast. As they come closer and closer, when they are in sea, they are continuously fed with moisture. So they grow, they intensify and become a cyclonic storm. When they come closer, about 300 kilometers, we have a set of cyclone detection radars in the east coast. Say for example, we have one in Karaikal, there is one in Chennai, there is one in Sriharikota, there is one radar at Machulipatnam, there is one radar at Vishakhapatnam, there is one at Paradeep, there is another one at Calcutta. So the range of these cyclone detection radars are 400 kilometers. So when it comes closer to the coast, about 400 kilometers, these radars will start collecting data about the cyclonic storm. When they still come closer, say about 100 kilometers close to the coast, we have got a line of coastal surface observatories, say Pamban, Tundi, Adirambatnam, Nagapatnam, Karaikal, Pondicherry, Kadalur, Chennai, Nellur, Obol, like that every 100 kilometers we have got a surface observatory. There, the surface pressure is measured using a mercury barometer. So as that comes, as cyclone comes closer to the coast, the pressure will start falling. So in where it is going to cross, some 50 kilometers away if we have a station, 50 kilometers below, say that is 50 kilometers north as well, 50 kilometers south if we have a surface meteorological station, the wind of these two stations will be exactly opposite. So the information that we get from these stations about the wind and about the pressure and about the present of the situation will tell us between which two stations the cyclone is exactly going to pass. So we can predict the presence of a cyclone at least 4 days in advance and will give effective warning about the cyclone about 24 hours in advance. Okay?
I want to know that why Delhi is more rainfall than Jodhpur.
Badri, this is a question that usually asked in 10th standard question paper geography. Normally state board, it is a standard question in state board. See, the Delhi gets rainfall because of systems that are forming in Bay of Bengal, moving across West Bengal, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh and comes up to Delhi. So as it comes from east to west, the rainfall becomes less. Calcutta gets at least 4 times more than rainfall of Delhi. See, now you are asking why Jodhpur is getting lesser rainfall from Delhi. It is like still east of Delhi. So the systems that are starting from the Bay of Bengal, when they reach Jodhpur, almost much are all exhausted, dry winds. Okay. Then the winds coming from Arabian Sea, they also used to bring lot of moisture. They should give enough rainfall over Jodhpur and all. But there is no natural barrier like a hill or mountain to block the movement of the air so that the air will block and go up and up above, form clouds and give rain. You have Aravalli ranges there. But Aravalli range is parallel to the flow of the wind. So they are not blocking the winds. So the presence of Aravalli hills are of no use as far as rainfall is concerned over Jodhpur or Rajasthan. That's why Rajasthan, Jodhpur gets lesser rainfall than Delhi. Right?
Good morning, good afternoon, sir. I am Anish and I want to ask you a question that in what ways the weather office helps the society or the common man?
Anish, I myself want to ask this question to you. You tell me, we are serving to the society. Do you happen to listen news or website or newspapers wherein the weather news are put?
Yes, sir.
See, our job is mainly to forecast the weather. We were forecasting it. But the society for the past 10 years, 20 years is improving a lot. There is a revolution in the communication world. So, we were no longer using landline telephone. Even if we have landline, we use only cordless. Mobile, internet, broadband, WhatsApp. So it's moving very, very fastly. So the dissemination of our forecast, in that way we help the people in telling them what exactly they want. Say, for example, one man is traveling in a car from Chennai to Trichy. He sees a big black cloud mass. He wants to know whether on his way there will be rain or not. We are issuing route forecast now. Travel forecast. Suppose I will be going to Coimbatore city tomorrow. I take today night tonight's train. I will reach tomorrow morning. I want to know whether it will be raining in Coimbatore. City forecast. We are issuing. I want to conduct one cycle rally from Tambaram to Trompet. In another 3 hours, whether it will rain or whether it will be, what will be the wind speed, I want to know. Because cyclists will have more difficulty in moving the vehicle when the wind is against them. We are issuing now cost for every 3 hours. It is there in our website. There is a website maintained by this office. The website's address is www.imdchennai.gov.in. If you go to that website, you have got nowcast, which gives forecast for next 3 hours. You have got city forecast, major cities within Tamil Nadu, we give forecast. 117 cities within India, we give forecast. Railway forecast, national highway forecast. All these things are there. Apart from that, aviation side, every airport we have our office, we give forecast. Agricultural side, we have tie up with all Kisan Vikas Kendras. We give their 5-day forecast to them. So, IMD, Meteorological Department, provides lot of service. No cost involved here. Everything is free. So, you need not pay. You can get every service free. IMD is providing all these services. Again, go to our website, you will get a lot of information. Right?
Yes.
Generally, people used to joke at us, telling them, suppose weather department says it will rain today, so we need not take umbrella at all, it will not rain. Okay? Like, but this is only a joke. We are also treating it as a joke only. You should know what is the science involved in this. Okay? I will explain you in a way in which you will understand. Suppose you have got two variables, x and y. To find out the value of x and y, you need two equations. You can solve that and find out. Suppose you have got three variables, x, y, z. Then you need three equations to solve that. How much time it will take? It will take more time than the two variable equations, isn't it? Suppose you have got five variables. Okay, how much equations you require? You require seven, not five. Because first you should remove out of the seven equations, two you have to you have to use two and remove one variable. Or two variables together, then make it three and solve. Okay, because in three variable method we are doing like that, only x we will remove or z we will remove, find out only x and y, solve that, and then we find out what is x, what is y, then substitute it, then find out z, isn't it? So like that, here this is a simple science which is based on simple laws. Newton's laws of motion, first law, second law, third law. You know, if I ask now, you will tell immediately. This forecast is based on that only, how the air is moving. Okay, then it is based on thermodynamics laws. Like that, very simple law, even 9th standard student can understand. But when you quantize them and make it in the form of an equation, you have got 17 variables. 17 variables means how much equations you want. Suppose you want to give input to all the 17 and find out the solution for each variable after 2 minutes. It takes at least 48 hours for you to do it manually. So when you use a computer, like a simple one like this, it will take at least 3 to 4 hours to do it. But sometimes it will hang, because it cannot handle. So you need a high processing speed computers, HPCs, with the teraflops speed. Okay. So when you give the data for finding out the values for next 2 minutes, it may take half an hour. Like that, half 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 2 minutes, you have to give, find out input, find out input, find out input, then you should find the value, what will be the temperature tomorrow, 24 hours, 48 hours. This is how the forecast is generated in computers. This is what is called as numerical weather prediction models. Today's forecasts are issued only in that way. Okay, suppose, where from this data comes, input, variables value, I have to put input, no, this the data comes from the field. He would have measured 33. While writing, he would have written as his 33 will look less 38. Somebody will send it as 38. Then what will happen? Today's data, it will take as 38 and will integrate. This error after 10 days, you will get maximum temperature after 10 days will be 65. You know very well, it cannot be 65 because your climatological normal will be 38 only. Then we will know it is a mistake and we will give some other value. So this is what is happening in weather. It is a simple science which can be understood by even 9th standard. But when you convert it into in the form of mathematical equations, non-linear, partial differential equations, solve them is a hectic job even with computers. That's why the forecast fails. Not only in India, all over the world. We try to improve it every day. We are trying to improve it every day and we are mostly successful, which is evident from the latest cyclone forecast what we are using in this year. They are all very 100%, we don't even 1 or 2 deaths. Such a neat warning we have. Right? Thank you.
Sir, we are taking a survey on brain readiness. Could you please fill up this survey form?